Hello, welcome to this video about how to add a central unit to the TELETASK Cloud. We start by using ProSoft 3.6. For this video, I'm using ProSoft version 3.6. I'm connected to a Nanos central unit over IP. To get started, we go to the communication menu and we see a new item, Cloud. When I click on this item, it will ask me to log in to the TELETASK Cloud. Now, as I don't have an account yet, I can click the Create Account button here, but of course, you can also do this directly on the TELETASK Cloud website. If I click this link, my browser will open up, and I need to enter some information. And then click Register. The website will now send me an email and that I need to use to verify the account. So an email has been sent and now I need to click on the link in the email I received. Here I have the email and here is the link I need to click. So I click on this link and again a browser window will open up that it's activating my account. Okay, account has been activated and then it will forward me to the login page where I can log into the TELETASK Cloud. Now at this point I don't need to log in because I'm doing some ProSoft work, so I'll just close all these windows and I'm back in ProSoft and I will use the email address and the password that I just used. And then I can log in and then it's verifying with the TELETASK Cloud that my credentials are correct. So, okay, I'm logged in as support at teletask.be and now I need to enter a name for this installation. Now this is an installation from a demo case. I'm connected to a demo case installation, so we'll call this demo case. Go. Connect installation to the cloud. Okay, we have now successfully connected our installation to the TELETASK Cloud. The next step is to add users for the TELETASK Cloud. To do this, let's go to the menu Extra and click Users and Settings. Now, of course, a user has a name, so let's create a user named Tony. Now, a user needs an email address because if the user hasn't got an email address, he won't be able to access the cloud. So you can't change this here. So let's give Tony an email address. And now I can change the cloud access. For the cloud, there are two types of users. There's an owner and a regular user. The regular user can use a GUI, but the owner can also use a GUI, and he can also change settings for users on the TELETASK Cloud website. He can, for instance, add new users, delete users. So in this case, we will make Tony an owner. If a proximity reader is installed in the installation, a user can also have a proximity tag or card. So let's give Tony a card number. There we have a card number for Tony. And then you can change that card number on the TELETASK Cloud website if necessary. Of course, you can add multiple users. Up to 250 users can be added to a TELETASK installation. So, but in this case, for the demo, we will keep it with one user. An important feature of the ISGUI is the use of IP cameras. Now, for the TELETASK Cloud, you don't need to have any specific network knowledge. You don't need to set IP addresses or ports or things like that. For the camera is the only exception. So let's add an IP camera. So we'll go to the menu Extra IP Cameras. I choose to create a new IP camera. Let's give this camera a name. Let's call it Front Door, for example. Now we add the URL for the camera. Now, important is that this URL is simply the URL of the local camera. So you can see a local IP address here. So it's an IP address that's starting with 192.168 and then the rest of the URL. And we have this new field here. It's called camera port for cloud access. Of course, for stability and speed reasons, the cameras do not go over the TELETASK Cloud. We access them directly. To do this, you need to set up port forwarding in your router from a specific port to the IP camera. For more information on how to set up the ports forwarding, check with your ICT provider. So in this case, we have set up port 10,000 to be forwarded to this camera. Okay, now let's set the other settings for this camera. Let's enter the username and the password for this camera. There we have it. And then we can test the video. Now it's important to know that testing the video from ProSoft tests the connection on the local network. Testing the video will not work if you're not connected to the local network. I will test the video and we can see I have an image from the camera. Okay, now we have set up this camera for use with the TELETASK Cloud. Of course, before we can use the IS GUI, we need to create an IS GUI in our file. So go to GUIsoft. Okay, there's no GUI yet. Let's make one. So we'll create an IS GUI, so for iOS or Android. And of course, we will choose this option, create the GUI based on the rooms and the icons. And there we go, our IS GUI is already created. So to summarize, we have connected the installation to the cloud, we have added a user, and we have added an IS GUI to our installation, and we've set up the camera for use with the TELETASK Cloud. Now we need to transmit our MBT file to the central unit. So transmitting the MBT file has worked. Now once the central unit has the running state, it will also indicate the connection status to the cloud in the lower right corner. So just need to wait for it to be running. There you have it. And now we can see that the central unit is connecting to the cloud. Connecting to the cloud may take a minute, as setting up the secure connection takes some time. So now we are done for the ProSoft part of setting up a cloud connection. Parts that remain is checking it on the website and testing an IS GUI. So now that we have added an installation to the TELETASK Cloud, we can verify it on the TELETASK Cloud website. Of course, we need to log in. With the email address and the password, sign in. And there I can see currently I have one location that I manage. The location is called Demo Case. It's owned by Tony, and I'm the system integrator. If I click this link, I can see the specifications of this installation. Now, it is important to know that by default, as a system integrator, I have access to the TELETASK Cloud and to IS GUI. This is very convenient during an installation phase. But as a system integrator, you are obliged to inform the end user that you have this access, and if the end user wants it, he can block this access for you. What can I see on this page? I can see a list of system integrators. Of course, this is me. I can see a list of users, and then I can see that there is one user. This is the user that we created earlier in ProSoft, and that is synchronized with the cloud by the central unit. Here I can see a list of devices, so if I now open this, I can see that the user Tony has already used IS GUI on two devices in combination with the TELETASK Cloud, so he has used an Android device and an iPad to connect his IS GUI. At the top, I can see the status of the connection from the central unit to the TELETASK Cloud, so I can now see that the nano central unit with the serial number is connected to the TELETASK Cloud. Now this is very interesting for you as a system integrator to know, because suppose a user contacts you that his connection to the cloud is not working, you can check this website to see if the central unit is connected to the TELETASK Cloud. If the status is here connected, then probably the problem is on the mobile device, because the central unit can connect to the TELETASK Cloud. Now also keep in mind, and this is important to tell the end user, if the end user blocks your access to his installation on the TELETASK Cloud, you won't be able to provide that service because you won't be able to see whether you are connected or not. So for your end user, this is a decision between service and privacy, let's say. There's also a little help menu here. This is mainly for the end user. So if your end user has a question on how to do something on the cloud, you can also refer them to this documentation. Now, at some point, it is possible that the end user will change some settings on the TELETASK Cloud websites. For example, he can change a card number or add a user or whatever. And if you then connect ProSoft to that central unit, you will see this notification that there's new data available on the central unit, and it requests me whether I want to download this new information. So I'll click yes here, and then it will start a receive action. It's already finished, because now I have the latest settings that the user changed. It can be so user information that's changed through the TELETASK Cloud website, but it can also be clock actions that have changed on an hour's TFT, for example, or presets for a sensor that have changed on an Aorus OLED or Aorus TFT. So in all those cases, simply you get a notification that there's new info available, download it from the central unit, and you have the latest information. I think this concludes this tutorial video about connecting a TELETASK central unit to the cloud.